Hi everybody, I hope you're having a great day. In this video, I'm going to be covering Conquest. He made his first appearance in Invincible, issue number 61, in April of 2009. Now, although we don't know his exact height and weight, we do know that he is a relatively larger and stronger Viltrumite male. Now, the Viltrumites are a race of powerful extraterrestrial beings. We do know he also has orange eyes and gray hair, and that he has a cybernetic right arm and a deep facial scar, and he's blind in his right eye. He's an old-school battle-worn warrior, and all of these injuries occurred during a traumatic period in the Viltrumite Empire's history. Now, Conquest is known to be a very psychotic and even sadistic individual, actually relishing the idea of battle. His Viltrumite physiology has given him several different superpowers. One of them is extremely slow aging, and he's likely lived to be thousands and thousands of years old, yet he's still in his physical prime. He also has dominant genes. If he or other Viltrumites have a child with a different race, their physical traits and appearance will override that of the race that they bred with. He has extreme superhuman durability and a healing factor, and therefore he can heal from things that would normally kill not only humans, but other species of aliens as well. He's been shown to have survived being completely disemboweled, touching lava, and even living through close range of a bomb blast. His Viltrumite physiology allows him to survive in space, and although he cannot breathe in that vacuum, they can hold their breath for up to 2 weeks. And it's almost a given that he has superhuman speed, stamina, and a strength level that's upper limits are completely unknown to us. The only blatant weakness that he and his species share is that they have a vulnerability to the imbalance of equilibrium in their inner ear. This is generally set off by extreme frequencies, and it can cause them pain and even kill them. Now, Conquest was born on the planet Viltrum, and he's one of the very few Viltrumites who actually survived a plague called the Scourge Virus. After this infection dissipated, he found himself temporarily vulnerable and his strength greatly reduced. It's during this time period that he was in a battle with the Rognarr, and this is when his right arm was ripped off, his face was permanently scarred, and he was blinded in his right eye. Conquest first shows up on Earth right after the Invincible War, and this was an event in which the supervillain named Angstrom Levy used his dimensional powers to bring about an army of evil alternate universe counterparts of Invincible to the main Invincible's world. This ended up being a huge battle between all the evil Invincibles and the rest of the world's superheroes. The good guys ended up winning, but the battle had actually decimated the face of the planet and left most of the heroes either dead or severely injured. Invincible himself is one of the very few heroes that was left healthy at that time. So, it was reasonable that the Viltrumite Empire had noticed this decimation that had occurred, and so that's why they thought this would be the perfect time to attack and conquer Earth. They sent Conquest as a scout to go out to see what Invincible had actually accomplished, and if he had not, for him to do it himself. When Conquest presented himself to Invincible, he told him, "Look, you either follow me and conquer Earth, or you'll die." Invincible actually tried to distract him by telling him that he caused a lot of the damage that was around him, but it didn't work. All the stress that Invincible had been through, and Conquest actually loving to fight, they ended up coming to blows. They had a very vicious engagement that caused even more destruction to the Earth that had already happened, and during this, Conquest proved himself to be stronger than Invincible, and more sadistic, explaining that he didn't want to kill Invincible because he was ordered to, but just because he wanted to. When Invincible starts to get beaten worse and worse, his half-brother Oliver jumps in to try to help him out. Oliver gets a few licks in on Conquest, but he's outmatched, but before Conquest could kill him, Invincible throws him away from the battle. Next enters in Adam Eve, who's Invincible's girlfriend, and she arrives and tries to help him out by containing Conquest with her force field, but Conquest easily breaks through him and then critically wounds her by punching a hole in her stomach. And to show how psychotic he is, Conquest actually pauses while Eve is dying in Invincible's arms to say that he hadn't had this much fun in a long time. Of course, this fuels Invincible to become even more vicious in his attack. They now go back at it again. Although this second round seems about evenly matched, Conquest is still slightly stronger than Invincible, although Invincible does get in a good rage-filled punch, which destroys Conquest's robotic arm. Much to Conquest's amazement, Eve actually regenerates herself and uses a power blast to burn off a lot of his skin. Invincible then maximizes on this and seems to kill Conquest with several headbutts to his face, leaving him badly disfigured. After some time went by, it was actually revealed that Conquest wasn't dead. He was actually just weakened and imprisoned in a 400-ton facility. Here he was being interrogated by some human special agents. After he completely heals up, he easily escapes and then flies into space to regroup with the remaining Viltrumites. They're a harsh species, and they were gonna kill him for failing to take over the Earth, but he begged for mercy from their leader Thragg, and he spared them just to give him the chance to go back and not fail for a second time. Conquest agrees, and then after receiving a new robotic arm, he takes two other Viltrumites with him to go back to Earth. He's relishing the idea of not only killing Invincible, but killing his father, Nolan, also known as the powerful being Omni-Man as well. When Conquest finds some of the heroes, he engages with Invincible's half-brother, Oliver, again. Oliver is quickly put out of the fight due to his inexperience. And Conquest, noticing Oliver's weakness, goes in to try to get an easy kill. Invincible's buddies take on the other two Viltrumites while Invincible goes to follow Conquest to help his brother. Now, this engagement happened in space, so when they were heading back into the Earth's atmosphere, Conquest made a crucial mistake and he exhaled before he could breathe again, and Invincible started to strangle him. This is one of the first times that Conquest shows concern that Invincible might kill him, so he then punched a hole in Invincible's stomach, just like what he did to his girlfriend Adam Eve. He thought that this would end the fight quickly, but Invincible fought through the pain and managed to hold on to Conquest and ended up strangling him to death this time. Now, due to his powers and abilities and his influence on the Image Comics universe, for my 1 to 10 rating, I'll give Conquest a rating of 7, which is a master rating. I hope everyone enjoyed this video. I'll talk to you next time. Be sure to like and subscribe to The New Sage.